If you're looking for some real rap, homie, I'm reliable. I bring the 90s to your ears like if they never pass. Cause if P brings fire, then I know that the gas. Time to start giving me credits or I'm taking no cash. If I feel $1 million, then the market is crashed. I'm from the ear of caps back, baggy jeans. Rapping what you really mean, packing every hood you beam.
I hope you like this music video. It was quite easy to do.
I'm Snoop Dogg, Smokey O with this hit. On the mic, I'm such an animal, my doctor's...
We made this nuclear lab. We also made a nuclear bomb, where pain can stand on it.
Yes, I'm a menace, a beast of limits. Leave the shit for those who really put their heart in it.
What else did we do? It was a complicated music video, you know? Then we found a bunch of tires in the 7-Eleven around the corner. And it's a special material that when it makes the smoke, it's not smoke, it's money. So they pay for themselves.
In my ear, I feel a rapper, then you prove you have bars. If you spoke the wrong bars, you would end up with scars.
We went into Counter-Strike and just killed all of them inside the map and got Pain alone in it, get him a gun on it. And then to get the shot of the gun, we just strap a camera to it. We made a city, but Pain didn't like it, so we burned it to the ground. He just came and he just said, fuck this shit. He burned the city to the ground.
Is it me or nothing really makes sense?
Does it make sense, bro? And you might ask, how did you go from this to this? So there's actually two methods to do this. We could do motion capture or we could do photogrammetry. And motion capture involves a lot of bones. And I don't want to deal with bones. I like to deal with potatoes.
After all, I did rappers like a cannibal. It's unbelievable.
Nice.
So just take a look at this. So into this program, I provided just footage of an actor, and I said, make this person an alien.
Okay.
I clicked a button. I said, make him an alien. An hour later, it spat this out.
So we used sequence photogrammetry. And this is how the basic, simple and basic, very simple process works.
All right, are we ready?
Wait. All right, so I will start to play back the music. After I start to play back, you go.
All right, what is the cue?
I will play, and you play. That's the cue. Whenever you tell me you're ready.
Okay, ready to keep on.
Rolling, everybody rolling, and I go.
Nine style, what I'm saying.
I bring the 90s to your ears like if they never pass. Cause if P brings fire, then I know that the gas. Time to start giving me credits or I'm taking no cash. If I feel $1 million, then the market is crashed. Oh shit, I don't like the sight I'm seeing one bit. Everything looks shiny but it's plastic, that's it, I guess. I'm Snoop Dogg, Smokey O with this hit. On the mic, I'm such an animal, my doctor's a vet. I break the flow lyric.
Now we jump to Cannibal. Ready, and...
All I see is ghost writers, I might have a sixth sense. Time to light up some candles and burn some incense. Cause I might not know much grammar, but I know you post tense. I know my shit is hard like a cannonball. After all, I eat rappers like a cannibal, it's unbelievable. They're halfway crooks, no talent, no looks. And the shit that I bring you, you can learn it in books, my man.
In the comments, man, fucking
we're here at Lumigrade's 3D scanning rig, sequence photogrammetry, volumetric video. What other names does it have?
It's a 4D scan lab.
4D scan?
Yeah, 4D scan, and then it's a lab. So I consider it as a lab, 4D scan lab.
So it's a lab of sequence photogrammetry with volumetric video that is volumetric.
4D scan lab.
All right. We've got how many cameras here?
We got 60 DSLR for T-pose and A-pose or whatever pose you have. That's for high res.
So photogrammetry means you're 3D scanning your body. All right. It means that you create a 3D model of your body. Photogrammetry is the creation of a 3D model. It can be a 3D model of a person, of an object, or anything. And it creates a 3D model with a texture attached to it. Here we are back in this location. Let me give you a quick example of photogrammetry. The way still photogrammetry works is through capturing many angles around the object that we want to scan. And then the computer can run an algorithm finding points in common throughout all these different pictures from the same object. And then calculate the distance to that point, the differential of the distance to that point with all the different pictures. And then from there, using trigonometry, it's capable of creating a 3D model. Let me give you an example with our potato right here. As opposed from the music video where we have 120 cameras all around with surround lighting, in this particular case, we're gonna do it on a cloudy day with a single camera. So I'm just gonna go around this potato. Now, the difference is that this potato is not moving. Our rapper, our artist, is definitely moving a lot. That's why we need to have 120 cameras shooting all at once. In this particular case, because this is not moving, I can just go around with a single camera and we're gonna get the same result. Doesn't matter how cold it is, how hot I feel or anything, I pick up a camera and I just start sweating out. So now that we have all of these pictures of the potato, it's just a matter of putting the potato inside the computer. And then the computer will transform this real potato into a 3D potato. Always keep in mind with photogrammetry, you don't want to have hard shadows because you create those shadows later inside the 3D environment. By the way, if you want to learn photogrammetry, all you have to do is pick up a phone and a lot of the software is free. I'll put links down below in the description.
Yeah, so what's the difference between videogrammetry and photogrammetry? Videogrammetry is the 25 frames. It's just multiplied by 25 or 50 frames, 50 objects per second. So it creates a sequence of all the moving objects. And then it creates a sequence, and then you can drop it into any environment, anywhere, and you can rotate your camera and then relight it in the way you want.
All right, you good to go, man?
You get it hard, Ricky.
In the 90s to your ears like if pain never passed. Cause if pee brings fire, then I know that the gas. Time to start giving me credits or I'm taking no cash. If I feel $1 million, then the market is crashed. Oh shit, I don't like this.
Down.
Your bars are laughable, I take the fake mask off. Nah, this ain't carnival. They're halfway crooks, no talent, no looks. And the shit that I bring you, you can learn it in books, my man. Here.
One of the challenges of doing a video like this is that the amount of footage that we get from that machine is really a lot. So we need to compress everything within 10 minutes. The way we do that is to like take parts of the song where I know that pain is looking towards the same spot, and compress those parts of the song within a 1 minute long take so that we could make about 9 takes in total.
Man, here I am with a mic in my hand and I treat it as a weapon, so just bring me your clap. I'm from the ear of cats, nice. Back, baggy jeans, pop and put.
Good, sweet, done.
Nice.
Vlogger?
Yes.
This one?
This is wobbling.
That's...
Whoa, whoa, wait, wait, wait.
3, 2, 1, go!
Cause in your ear if you have views, you can say you're a star. But don't expect to get respect if you don't know who you are. Is it me or nothing really makes sense? All I see is ghostwriters, I might have a sixth sense. Time to light up some candles and burn some incense. Cause I might not know much grammar, but I know your past tense.
So this one right here. So what exactly is going on here in this camera setup?
It's a nested system that we have DSLR here, and then it has to maintain the same angles of the volumetric field camera. So these are on the 120 cameras all around you.
So there's 60 DSLRs and 60, what's the top?
It's a FLIR camera, it's an industrial camera, and
wow.
It can capture 73 frames per second.
The camera is connected to this very cool USB that's got like screws on it, like safe, you know, it's a safe USB. Never
said this.
This is fucking.
No, this is a what they call GPIO cables. It is used to synchronize all the cameras, all 60 cameras, at a very precise timing. Super precise timing.
Okay, okay,
and then after that, all the data will be nested. Five cameras will be into one PC. And then
so it's
we
five
have,
cameras per PC, yeah?
Yeah, five cameras per PC.
So how many PCs you got then?
I got 12 computers right here running the whole system.
So,
and
okay.
The challenge, the very big challenge is the, five cameras. It's gonna throw all the data to the PC at once. And then you have to maintain that in 2 or 3 or 4 minutes. Continuously, and that is a very, very tricky situation that you have to deal with the hardware.
So you got like five cameras plugged through USB into the computer, like feeding in all of the data, right? And then from those computers, where does the data go to?
Okay. And all the data will flow straight to the NAS right here, through the 10G network.
Oh shit, yes. Bring the guns up, baby.
You're in GTA, you're going with the gun, right? And then like, you're gonna run to the camera and you start to grab to the camera. And then you start to wrap to the camera, and that's it. Okay?
Which camera?
This is one of the biggest challenges of doing a video like this, is to figure out where is the eyesight of the person. Because one of the reasons why I'm holding the handheld camera is to give something for paint to look at. And the real challenge is to find out later on, once we have the 3D scans, where was that camera? Where actually was Payne looking at? This is actually very complicated and really difficult to solve. So we pretty much eyeball it. And this is one of the reasons why I had so many cameras around the behind the scenes shooting. So that this way I would know where was that camera position, and then I could try to replicate that within 3D.
Nice. Ooh.
So camera's here, so you start here. Okay, you go like that. And then you turn around, you make
Exactly.
It's taken, then one more, and that will be done, man. That's it. That was fast.
Whoa. Okay, ready?
You ready? Yeah?
Yep.
Payne, ready? Wait, hang on.
So you fucked up my shirt, bro?
Let's go.
Fuck it, you don't know what to mean. In my ear, I feel a rapper, then you prove you have bars. If you spoke the wrong bars, you would end up with scars. In your ear, if you have views, you can say you're a star. But don't expect to get respect if you don't know who you are.
Yeah, sure. You like this computer game? Laptop?
Wow.
It's a laptop.
That's what I want to build before, man.
Yeah.
Remember?
Laptop.
This is a laptop?
Yeah.
That's pretty bonkers.
Some incense. As a mind, I know much grammar, but I know you must tense. I know my shit is hard like a cannonball. After all, I need rappers like a cannibal. It's unbelievable. Put the pen down, your bars are laughable. And take the fake mask off. Nah, that's incredible.
So all the data will go through my file server, and then everything will be processed afterward in the final computers. We have three computers for ending line processing. So each computer will be equipped with graphic cards, and then it requires a really high performance graphic card. And CPU as well, so that it can calculate all the object and at a very fast return time.
He bought the GPUs when they were expensive, that's why he's mentioning that.
Oh, don't cry, are you?
As you can see right now,
check out the system.
Yeah,
the system.
I'm controlling all the 12 computers right now, and then it doing its own calculation right now, so per take. So we got 9 takes today, 9 or 10, and right now it's processing right here. And after processing, automatically it will push to the file server, and then I just take it. The process, are you happy with what I...
No, just say that my music is the best.
Does it make sense, bro? Let me bring you through a speedrun of the basic, simple process to make this.